It's Missy, and I'm very excited to be here today at Spellbinders to help celebrate the new Jane Davenport release. And I was sent several of her new products to play with, and so today I'm going to share a layout process with you, and I hope you guys enjoy it. I had a really fun time putting it together, and I'm going to show you all the products that I received. There are a ton more, but these are just the ones that I was sent to play with, and they're all gorgeous. So the first thing that I was inspired by was this beautiful set of feather dies over there on the right of my screen. And these are called Fair Feathers. And I wanted to punch them out of something very colorful. And so I pulled out my Jane Davenport watercolors and just a sheet of paper from my watercolor notebook of things. I have a little notebook that I practice and play around in. So I just tore a sheet out of that. So it's not cardstock, but it's not watercolor paper, but it's not going to matter because I'm going to die cut those feathers out of it. So this looks like a hot mess. All I'm doing is slapping down some color here. I wanted to go with bold, bright colors because when I think of Jane Davenport's gorgeous art, I think of bright, bold colors. And so those are my favorite colors also. So I'm going to use some pinks, some blues, and some yellows mostly, and just get this paper covered. And it's not going to matter how messy it looks or how splotchy it looks because we're going to die cut some feathers out of it. And this is a great way if you want to have a mixed media look on your project, but you really don't want to put all this watercolor or paint down on your background. This is basically a scrap sheet of paper here, and you can make the biggest mess on it all you want, and once you die cut shapes out of it, it looks completely different. And so once you get the feathers cut out, then you've got a mixed media look, but it's all nice and neat in a die cut shape, if that makes any sense. So this is all dry, and I actually like how that looks. I love all those colors. I'm going to show you one of the inks that I got, and I had a hard time picking and choosing, but I had to have the gold. And I'm also going to use one of her stamps. This stamp set is called Mad Confetti, and I love this little cluster of circles. Now this gold ink is called Gold Bullion. And I've already played with it before I started filming, but when you open the ink pad for this gold color, it's empty. And it comes with this little bottle of the gold ink, and you have to shake it up really, really well and get some in the dropper, and then you just squeeze some onto the pad and rub it into the pad using a little circular motion there. And you could use as little or as much as you want, but it's going to work really, really well with the stamps. And so what I thought I would do before I started to cut up this background paper here was add some shimmery detail to it. And that's what I love about this gold ink is that it's bold and it's shiny and shimmery and metallic. And I could not pass up the opportunity to work with gold because who doesn't love gold, right? So I just stamp it a couple of times around on this paper just to add some pops of shine. And then we're going to get to cutting out some feathers. So you can see there how shimmery and sparkly it is. So I was sent this. I was so excited when I opened this. Look how gorgeous this machine is. This is the Deep Sea die cutting machine. It's got Jane's artwork on it. Oh, it's beautiful. So if you've ever used a manual die cutting machine, this one is amazing. It comes with the plates, it comes with all you need to die cut and emboss. So it's all there, and all the notes that you need to know are written on the printed on the biggest plate, so you don't have to keep up with any papers. It's all right there. So all I'm doing, I cut my sheet of paper in half, laid down the dies, and I'm gonna roll it on through, and it's gonna die cut these feathers out. Now I wish I would have rolled it back through. I'm gonna have to show you what I didn't really make a mistake, but trial and error. I think it's gonna cut better, but since these feathers have such intricate little pieces, there's so many pieces that have to pop out. If you roll it through twice, and I only rolled it through once, and so some of them popped out really easily. And then some of them were kind of stuck. And so what I'm going to wind up doing to make sure that it's a crisp, clean cut is I'm going to put it back on the cutting mat and roll it back through again. and then all the little pieces come out with no problem. So yeah, you can start to see how this is going to look, but before I take anything else up, I'm going to run it back through. And these are just things you learn. It was a brand new machine to me, and I hadn't used it, so you know, it was just sort of a practice run to see how this turned out, and I really love how it looks. But my advice would be to run it through forward and at least run it back through backwards and maybe even another pass through. But you're gonna see here how pretty they're not flowers, feathers turn out. And it looks totally different than the splotchy watercolor background that I just made. That's the beauty of this, is your background can be something that you think is ugly, which I don't think this is ugly. I love the colors. But I know sometimes we get to making backgrounds and things and you don't like the color combination or you want to throw it away. You know, I don't like this. This is not what I wanted. But don't throw it away. Cut something out of it like this. Look how pretty those feathers are. And the colors just sort of blend. And now I've got multicolored feathers. And I was so excited about how beautiful they turned out. I mean, the detail on these dyes is fantastic. So all I'm going to do is the same thing that you just saw me do. We're going to do another pass through. I'm going to try to use up all the paper that I colored and create a bunch of feathers. And I kind of have an idea of the layout design and what I'm going to do with these feathers. But it's very addicting. When something turns out this pretty, you just want to keep on making it because everything looks so nice. So here they all are, and I'm going to use some thick white cardstock as my background. And it's smooth. I believe it's the double thick cardstock. And I'm going to scrap this cute black and white picture of my daughter. And before I do anything, I can't just have a solid white background. I have to zhuzh it up. So I'm going to come back to my watercolors and pull some of the same colors that I used on the feathers. And this is the packaging technique. I know you've seen people do this left and right. It's my favorite way to get splotchy watercolor look on the background. And you kind of never know what it's going to look like. I mean, you have an idea, but every time you do it, it looks different. And I always love how this turns out. So I thought I would create sort of a vertical design over on sort of the left side of the layout with the feathers kind of falling above and below and underneath the photo. And I wanted some watercolor on the background beneath the feathers and the photo. So here's another way to use the gold ink. I just squirted some onto some plastic, watered it down, and splattering it. I'm going to also use the packaging technique with this ink. So you don't have to necessarily use it for stamping. It looks beautiful in this way as well. If you want big drops like that, just get it nice and wet and then hold it up high and squeeze the bristles down with your fingers, and you're going to get some big splatters. So I love how this is looking, and it's going to look totally different once I bring the photo and all the feathers back on top of it. And I like to use a roll of paper towels to just kind of roll right over everything to dab up anything. Sometimes when you try to dry up splatters, you can smush it down and it will make the splatter kind of misshapen. But when you roll a paper towel roll over it, it does not do that. And it took me a long time to figure that out. But now that I know that, it works out great. Okay, so here is the pink ink that I received, and it's called Scallop Shell, and it's a really pretty deep pink. And I'm going to use the circles again, and I really love the contrast of that deep pink up against the watercolor pink. And I'm just going to keep building my background here, adding in more color here and just more splatters. And the inks are, let me see here, I have them in my hand. They are acid-free, they're archival, they're waterproof, alcohol marker friendly once they're dry, fade and smear resistant. They can heat set on glass, fabric, wood, plastic, metal, and clay. So, yeah, those are awesome. So I decided to add more of the pink circles. So I just decided to kind of make a cascade of the dots since I'm going to have a cascade of the feathers. And I like to kind of work on the background and then bring everything back on top of it just to see how it looks. And I'm not going to use any pattern paper or anything like that on this layout. I'm going to strictly use the materials from this release. I do add some tissue paper and some adhesive foam behind my photo just to kind of give it a little something something to raise it up off the page and give it a little bit of subtle separation between the background and the photo. And then I'm going to come back in with the feathers and just kind of start to layer them down. They just look like they're kind of raining down. So once I got all that down, I noticed that the very top and the very bottom was, it was so dark with the dark pink that I was losing the flowers. So I'm just going to take a little bit of white gesso and kind of soften up the top and the bottom, not completely make it invisible, but just soften it up so you can see the feathers in that area. So here's another stamp set that I received. It's got flowers on it and it's called Build a Bouquet. Several different size flowers, and so I'm going to take the medium size little, I'm not sure what kind of flower that is, but I'm going to use the black ink, which is called Cave Black, and the teal ink, where did it go? Right here. The teal ink is called Mermaid Eyes. Is that not perfect for a Jane Davenport ink? And these inks are called Squid Inks. Genius. Love it. So I thought I would add a couple of little random flowers in. So I stamped them in the teal and the black, and I'm going to layer some around the photo, and then I'm going to add a little cluster over to the right. I am going to lightly glue down the feathers, just with a little bit of glue right down the middle, because I am going to wind up stitching through some of them. And I know that flowers and feathers don't necessarily go together, but I like how this turned out. And so I say, if you like the way it looks, go for it. It doesn't have to match the theme, or if you like the way it looks, then use it. Now, for my little cluster over to the right, I'm going to go back in with the gold and do the packaging technique again. And then off camera, I did some stitching. And then right there where my photo is, I was playing around with some of the other stamps, and I just stamped there because I knew my photo was going to cover it, and I decided to not use those. So that's what that was. But I am going to use these smaller flowers that I stamped and fussy cut out. One thing I love to do on my layouts is add thread. And so I pulled from my stash three colors. I've got the teal aqua color, I've got the darker royal blue color, and then the darker pink. And I'm just going to layer in some of that to add to the whole messy factor on the background. It's going to add pops of color, it's going to add texture. And then I'm going to work on gluing everything down, as well as the stamped flowers. I didn't know where I wanted the stamps, or not the stamps, the flowers. And so that's why I stamped them on some scrap white cardstock and fussy cut them out. And so I've instantly created an embellishment. And now I can move it around and layer it or just stick it wherever I want. So I'm going to layer one on top of the photo and then the other ones underneath the photo and then this one over here to the right. So I had three feathers left over and I didn't want to leave the right side of my layout completely white, and so that's why I like to add little clusters in. If I'm gonna do part of a layout that's on one side or just on the top or just on the bottom, I like to add a little something in the naked area. I come back in with the pink and add some more circles, and then come back in with matching splatters. Since I have all the splatters of all the colors on the left, I'm going to add a little bit of that over here on the right. And then now I have the perfect spot for my title, which is going to go right there to the right of the photo. More gold. When in doubt, add more gold, right? A couple of big splatters over there. I am going to add one more flower. I'm going to pop it up with some foam and then come in with my pink thread and create a little nest of thread around that flower because I felt like I needed a little more pink in that area. Now, this stamp inspired me to use it in my title. It's from the Mad Confetti stamp set, and it's called, or it says Wild and Free. So I wanted to go kind of small with my title, and so I pulled out some random little tiny skinny black alpha stickers, and I made my title Believe You Can Fly because I thought it kind of tied in with the feathers. And I wanted to use the Wild and Free stamp, and I just got bold and stamped it right onto the background there. And the word fly is from an old, really old pack of thickers that I have in my stash. So I kind of combined and mixed and matched. And then I decided I need some more pops of black around the page. And so I went back to the Build a Bouquet stamp set and pulled out the tiniest flower on there. And then I'm just going to go through and lightly stamp it with the black ink, the Cave Black, and just kind of stamp it in a couple places. And I'm getting close to being finished. I really love how this turned out. I love that it looks messy and colorful and just kind of artsy. And I love creating layouts like that. I'm going to add some black splatters by watering down some of the Cave Black ink. And then one of the last things I'm going to do is add in some lines for my journaling. And I'm going to write a couple of lines about my free-spirited child. And then I think the final photos are coming up. Yep, there it is. I love how this turned out. I hope you guys are inspired. I hope that you will try out some of these new Jane Davenport products because they are so inspiring. They're beautiful, fun to work with, and there's so much to choose from. So definitely check it out and let me know if you have any questions about anything that I did or any of the products. And yeah, we will get back with you. So I appreciate you guys watching and hope to see you in another video soon. Take care.